abilities and to create within us.
Oh, that actually is
all different uses. We can use many different Jeremys and Matts at our disposal.
I was actually reading about the power of thought and thought control from the Buddha and the Buddha Buddhist text this morning, you know. And how you can really send out a lot with your thoughts, you know.
Your thoughts are all powerful.
Yeah, and you know, like, what did it say? Like something like, you know, when the wind blows, you know, the flowers that drift away with the wind can be taken by the wind, you know. They can go against the wind, you know. But thought control doesn't go against the wind; it goes directly to the source, you know.
That's right.
There's nothing that pushes it around, makes it float around the sky. You know, your thoughts are direct. You know, they will directly affect somebody. They can directly change a vibe, become a vibe.
That's right.
You know, I mean, there's a lot of power within your thought. You know, you just don't know it, maybe. You know.
You don't know it, but you're still doing it. That's why I think in yesterday's video we were talking about first impressions and things you feel when you're around people. That's their thought you're feeling. Their thoughts are kind of creating their vibe, and you're picking up on your vibe using your intuitive sense, your sixth sense, which is true. That it's not five senses, but six.
Yeah, I wanted people to realize that, you know, like they're saying, if they're saying, you know, while, you know, Matt and Jeremy are saying that the thoughts are also powerful, but it's not only Matt and Jeremy, it was the Buddha, it was Christ, it was all the religious leaders,
Muhammad,
if you look at other powerful people in the world, you know what their idea was or their thought.
Their thought was created.
Yeah, it was created reality for them, you know.
That's their biggest secret in this world. There's a book called The Secret, which deals with thought control and thought formation, creating realities. But it is a secret. The biggest secret in the world is that each and every person is all-powerful Lord.
Yeah.
You know, that, and whose thoughts are all powerful and that can create anything or destroy anything.
Yeah.
You know, that's the biggest secret of governments and everything. That's what they don't want you to know.
Yeah.
That you're all powerful and you don't need them. You don't need any government. You don't need any law to tell you what to do. Each and every one of us is God, powerful, fully powerful and capable of anything.
Fully loaded
with the power of the universe and then you, at the tip of your hands, you know, your fingertip. You know you can do anything, create anything, destroy anything at the most speed of your thought. And it wasn't just Christ sitting there. Christ taught that, you know, but it's not, you don't have, a lot of people miss that part. They'll say, well, you got to believe in Christ and his Lord and Savior. But Christ actually said, look, you know, you know, put what I said to the test. Why are you so amazed at me?
Yeah.
You know, you can do this too and more.
Yeah.
You know, he's telling people to do what he did. And then that's what the church conveniently misses. They're like, oh, you just got to accept Christ as your God. You know, when Christ actually taught you are your own God.
Yeah,
just like me.
Because, you know, they always have these bracelets and stuff. What would Jesus do?
And Jesus would tell you to do anything you want.
Yeah,
and create your own reality.
If you were acting like Jesus, you know, you'd be doing a lot more, you know, even more and more. You know what I'm saying? You'd be doing so much more. Think of all the forgiving you could do and all the past judgment you could do if you were acting just like Christ, you know. Think of all the walking, you know, the ability to walk on the water.
Yeah, that's simple stuff, but that's possible.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, you know. Like,
well, you can do a lot more than that.
Yeah, you can.
Why don't you go ahead and heal all the sickness in the world by thinking about it?
Exactly.
Why don't you do any stuff like that?
You know, that's what Jesus would do. And, you know, like, that's the idea, you know. If you're striving, if it's a reminder all the time, you know, there's a lot of good people in this world, but I just wanted to say that. You know, that quote always, what would Jesus do? Well, if we were doing as Jesus was doing, we'd be doing it, what me and Matt do, plus more. We'd be able to float around and stuff. You know, we'd do exactly what we had faith, total faith in ourselves like Jesus had himself.
That's where we're headed, you know. We're headed towards absolute knowledge. That's our goal, our spiritual goal. Is to attain absolute knowing and creative powers and creating our own realities as we see fit instantly, consciously. That's what Jeremy and I are choosing to do and what we teach others to do. You know, our only thing we want to do in this world is teach people how to be gods.
Yeah.
Gods. How to teach all of you how to be your own lords and lord of self.
Yeah. You know, what would you do? You know,
what would you do? Don't know what Jesus do. What would you do? That's the question Christ is asking you now.
Yeah.
If you believe in the Lord Christ, same thing might come from Lord Buddha, Lord Muhammad, Lord Christian. Krishna, excuse me.
You should follow all the leaders.
Take their ideas, you know, and enroll with them on your own, though.
Yeah. I mean, what would Martin Luther King do?
Yeah.
I mean, you know what I mean? Like,
he did it, created his own reality, too.
Yeah. I mean, if you want knowledge from a certain leader, so think about your situation. You know, think about what the leader did, you know.
That's right.
Think about what you would do now being in the shoes of being the next
leader. Being the leader. You need to see yourself as a leader. Know that you're a leader. Begin, you'll become that leader.
Yeah.
You know, Jeremy and I, all our lives, have wanted to be spiritual teachers and leaders.
Absolutely.
And then and here we are in our 30s, and we're manifesting that the time has come. Mm-hmm. You know? And we're here to change the world.
Yeah.
Let me put it bluntly. You know, our job is to change the world. You know,
change the way people are thinking.
That's
change
correct.
The way people are going. You know,
we're here to help young people more, most of all. Yeah, you know, because the youth need to know this stuff because they're going to be another generation coming up to them. Mm-hmm. And once they know this stuff, they'll be the teachers teaching their children this stuff.
Yeah,
that's what we're doing. We're doing paradigm shifts by creating a whole new thought paradigm in young people.
Yeah,
and we're here to change it all up. We're here to switch up the whole world.
Man, we're trying to make an impact, you know, where people change for the better, you know.
That's correct.
And we're taking
we're putting it into our own hands. We're not sitting here praying to some God, asking for God to do it. We're taking action.
We're taking action. We're taking the advice from the infinite, from the leaders, from our own knowledge.
That's right.
You know, we're starting to...
We're not wasting time praying.
How many times do you have to read a book?
How many times
do
you just sit and pray and read a book and like, God, please change the world and nothing happens?
Yeah.
Why do you think nothing happens? Because God teaches people that you're God. You have full power. It's on you to do it. Don't wait for him. Take action on your own.
Yeah, I mean...
You're the God.
There's no big giant man is going to reach out and rescue you from...
That's right.
You know,
that's never going to happen.
You know, and every time you screw up, there's not some man grabbing at your foot to the burning pits.
That's right.
You got to keep on trucking. You know, you got to keep
on... It's on you.
Yeah, it's on you.
You do it. If you don't do it, it won't be done.
You know, you keep beating yourself up for what you've done and your sin and all this. You know, you're not going to get anywhere. You know, you got
to
move
on. Time to forget about that, too. Forget punishing yourself. That's all you're doing is punishing yourself, thinking... That's why certain humans wrote stuff like that in, for example, the Bible, like, oh, everybody's born in sin, everybody's worthless, this little worthless things, and God's furious at everybody, and, you know, because they don't want people to know their true power. It's in the governments and in the corporate interests and so forth that this stuff can be suppressed as much as possible. We're telling you big secrets here.
Yeah.
We're telling you stuff that they do not want you to know.
Absolutely.
And me and Jeremy don't give a rat's ass what they think.
No.
We're going to speak the truth because it is the truth.
Yeah.
I mean, you are powerful gods, every one of you. You can do anything. It doesn't matter what any government, what any law says. You know, the only law that you need to know is that you're a god.
That's right.
And God made you a god of your own and gave you the power to create anything. And it's time you put that power to use. Get off your ass what would you do? Quit asking what would Jesus do, or even what would Matt do, and what would Jeremy do? What would you do if you knowing that you're God, if you're the God, what are you going to do?
Yeah, you know the 100%. You know, you already know in you 100% what the right thing is to do. What
look for that soul guidance.
Yeah, you know what your destiny is. You know what you can.
It's already there.
Yeah, you can become what you want. You know, you have to put yourself to head of the game. You know.
Correct. You have to just go with your soul power. Start trusting everything. Go with whatever happens in your life and trust everything, the good and the bad. Start with that. Start accepting it all. And that's the best thing you can do to start. Because before you know it, you'll be headed the way you want to be headed.